Now let's talk about the centrifugal tension. So this is a belt, or this is a pulley on which a belt is running. So this is how it is rotating. Due to the rotation, let us say that there is a certain amount of centrifugal force which starts to act on the belt. So it starts to pull away the belt. Okay. Due to this centrifugal force, there are centrifugal tensions produced in the belt. So we'll again assume a short length between the points AB. So this much length of belt is being assumed, which is making an angle delta theta at the center of the pulley. So let us say the mass per unit length of the belt, mass per unit length of the belt is equal to m. Okay, so for this much length AB, okay, so for AB, the mass would be m into the length of that arc, which is r into delta theta. Alright, so the centrifugal force which is acting on this, which is mass per unit length into velocity square upon r. So mv square upon r, which gives you mv square into delta theta. Now if you look at these two tensions, alright, so the triangle will become like this, the force triangle. So this is FC, this is TC, this is TC, and this is delta theta by 2, and this is also delta theta by 2. So if you resolve this in the vertical direction, so you will get FC is equal to TC into sine of delta theta by 2 plus TC into sine of delta theta by 2. So you can add these two. You get 2 into TC into sine of delta theta by 2. Now, this angle is so small that this sine can be taken to be almost the angle. So, this would give you TC into delta theta. So, FC is equal to TC delta theta and MV square delta theta. We can equate these two. So, you will get TC delta theta is equal to MV square delta theta. So TC comes out to be MV square. So this is the value of the centrifugal tension. Okay, so if you have to calculate the effective tension now in the tight side, let us say this is T1 and this is T2. So the effective tension in the tight side would be T1 plus TC. And the effective tension on the slack side would be T2 plus TC. Okay, so make a note of this expression and the analysis along with it. So I hope you got it. Now in the next video, we'll look at a condition for the maximum power transmission with the help of a belt.